I'm at the Palomar Boatyard. About quitting time, everyone else is sitting around drinking beer, except for me. These are our couch cushions behind me from the cockpit. We got a pretty decent price on new ones, so we're gonna ditch these. I'm sunburned, tired, dirty, and I'm going home. Luckily, the boatyard is 2.25 blocks away from our apartment, so pretty cool. And there's a liquor store between now and there, so I'd have to get a cold one. All the stuff we're having now. Nobody plays Buddy Holly down here. So the pads that I dropped off here last night, big stack here, is all gone this morning. So it seems like everything we throw off the boat, trash compactor, pads, expired food and water that's been in the sun and plastic containers forever. A bunch of just anything, everything. Old cords and ropes and screens and crap.
These guys, broken chairs.
These guys grab it and it's like some sort of Christmas.
Old life jacket.
So anyway, this blue business that's all around us, that is a 200 ton crane that they just had shipped in here from Italy. And there's a lot of people working on it, but it is a big deal. That'll be the biggest, I think they already had the 100 ton crane. It was already the biggest. Anywho.
Off to work we go.
It looks like much is happening. Yesterday, they had to stop all of our work crews, boatyard crews and our sanding crews, because this boat over here was getting some kind of clear coat and they couldn't have any dust anywhere. So hopefully it's dry now and we can get back to work. Fingers crossed.
We're also getting some wood stain repair work done here. So that's pretty cool. Can't really see anything in here, but yesterday this is all like black and gross. And now it's looking pretty good.
What's he painting?
Paint remover on the bowsprit and get that all cleaned up. We got a welder coming too, supposed to be here today, so he won't be here till tomorrow.
But, I thought he was coming today.
Yeah, right, that's why he won't be here till tomorrow. But he's gonna do some more work up on that pulpit there. It's kind of a rickety situation, and so we need to have some welding done. Some little steel plates and some new bolts put in.
This is Sandra and her team from Canvas Work. They are creating new cockpit cushions for us. Since the old ones we trashed were scratched, scuffed, faded, and had cigarette burns throughout several of them. So we got a great price quote from Sandra, and she had a great turnaround time for us too. So we're excited to see her finished product. Here she is with her team measuring all of the areas that need to have the new cushions.
Somehow we've been locked out of her.
Oh! Yeah. Yikes! What happened? Is it locked?
I'll take it apart and fix it.
Okay. We have been told the master is clean. Looks beautiful. Even in the bathroom, which was so gross, I couldn't even step foot in it. Look how nice it looks, so clean. Well, you have a few boo-boos here and here from when we tried to remove a toothbrush holder, which was disgusting, and a soap dispenser, which is not needed, like a bar soap, which we don't use out here. And we'll put some wallpaper on it and it'll be good as new. Shower is nice and clean.
Heading back to the boat yard. It's about 8:15 in the morning.
When we got up at 6, by the time we were having coffee at 6:30, it was 82 degrees outside. It's going to be 100 today.
We have 3 o'clock today with the riggers, and I'm hoping that he can get us 600 feet of quarter inch Dyneema.
Which you can't.
Apparently it's like non-existent here in this country. The import fees are off the chart.
Some mornings we show up
and there's people waiting for us, and other times we show up and there's nobody here for another hour. So Mexico time.
Yeah,
so
is this okay? No. All the bombs here and
at the moment, we have three crews working on our boat, which is pretty impressive. We've got riggers. Apparently, everything under the bed has to be, under the bed, which is all of the steering, has to be completely replaced. It's fraying, stretched out, no bueno. So they're going to start on that immediately, and we also have our cleaning crew slash wood sanders on board, and then a guy somewhere working on the hole down below, outside the boat. Anyway, very busy place to be, people everywhere. I think there's four cleaners and three riggers, plus Chris and me, and that's just inside. I guess you wouldn't be hired as a rigger if you can't get to the top of a mast, though, huh?
I love what he's doing. It's like a 16 inch long sanding pad. It's awesome. It's gonna look really smooth after it gets painted. I can't wait. Okay.
I'll fix it. It'll be good as new.
Alright. You know what's up.
I was a carpenter for 7 years. I can fix it.